Hi, Jenny Bear here. I wanted to really quickly show you how I do the recipes, how to digitize them. I was going to make you a real nice and pretty video, but I didn't have time yesterday. I didn't have time today, and I'm out of town tomorrow. So just in the interest of time, let's go at it. I use Procreate, and that's this button right here. And then I have everything saved on my camera roll. If you wanted a new blank one, you'd use this plus. But since it's on my camera roll, I can tap photo. And here is the original recipe that Shannon provided me with. Thank you very much. You can pinch to see all the edges. And then I'm gonna make another layer. And this is where we'll be doing everything. But before I show you how to do it, I just wanna show you a couple other things. I wanna go to the wrench, add, insert a photo, and yes, this is the one that Shannon did with Adobe Capture, I believe it was. And so if you zoom in, you see it lost a lot of information. So in my head, that's less than ideal. And then let's add another one, insert a photo. And I did this already last night, just to see. And here is the way I do it. And you can see it's pixelated because it's still a pixel-based art, but you'll take care of that on the end game. So I want to show you how to do this. And just as a quick comparison, here are all three of them. So here's the original, here's Adobe Capture, and here's my method. So these all came in on different layers, so let's go ahead and hide them until we get to the original handwritten, which is here. Let's add a layer, and here's where we're going to be working. I like to turn the opacity on the original down a little bit. Make sure you come back up to layer 5. Go to your brushes, go to inking, and technical pen. These come standard on all Procreate apps. Tap it again. This will probably come streamlined to about there. And if you do that, you can see it's not great. If you take this all the way up, you see how it smooths it. So take your streamlining all the way up. Hit done. It will accept those changes. And tap that to make that go away. Let's make sure we're on this layer. We are. Back to the brush. And here's the big secret. I trace it. Now you think, okay, well, tracing, that's not really the recipe. No, well, neither is taking a picture. But I feel like I'm doing this, and I'm doing this with intention. And I'm keeping every bit of the intention and integrity. And you don't want to think about it as whoever wrote this, whether it's Mrs. Sykes or Mrs. Sykes' beloved niece or neighbor. You just want to picture that this was given to someone lovingly and with great appreciation. And I like to keep that intention in my head, and you can roll your eyes now. That's just fine with me. But you want to go slowly and try and stick with it as closely as you can. Now I'm gonna go off. Oops, well, that's terrible. Two finger undo. Try again. And you wanna lift your pencil every now and then. Otherwise, you may have to redo an entire word if you go off the strokes a little bit. And you just nice and easy go about it. You try and notice little clues, like, do you see right here? It's a little darker at the entry point. And so my head, she went down. And that is how it got darker in that particular spot. And go slow. I can't emphasize that enough. Go slowly, as my father would have said to me if he would have heard that. And you just keep going. Okay, that's bad. I'm gonna two-finger undo. Started out bad. Let's undo it again. That's the beauty of being able to lift your pencil and you can get everything as perfect as you desire. Remember, lift that pencil every now and then. And don't think of it as handwriting. You're copying strokes as though it were a drawing. However, knowing how letters are formed is obviously helpful because you know that this probably started here and came there. She made a real little O there. That's okay. We'll just copy that. And I don't like to correct anything. If something's wrong, it's not my place to correct. However, if something looks like it just got old, like the paper just got old and compromised, like this is clearly, well, not clearly, but in my head, this isn't supposed to be there. Two finger to undo. So I would not continue with that. But you just nice and slowly. And you can make this as big or as small as you feel comfortable to get the strokes as exact as you want. And you just keep going. And so when you hide this layer, you see it looks pretty good. So again, let's turn this off and see the various methods. You have the Adobe Capture, you have the original, and you have the traced. And there's the big secret. I hope you got something out of this. Please let me know if you have any questions, and I'd be happy to expand.